For him.
And
that's why the Bible says, don't give Satan an opportunity. So Adam was living in safety with his wife. And God was relating with them daily, continuously. God is a loving God.
He
is called love. And love never fails. God loves you so much. He loved Adam and Eve. And he still loves us. The evidence was when Adam sinned, God provided atonement. When Lucifer sinned, he became Satan. And he became the devil, the serpent. He was cursed. When Adam and Eve sinned, God never cursed them. Instead, he punished them like a good father who punish a child who's going wayward. There is nowhere in the Bible where it is written that God cursed Adam. God cursed the earth because of Adam. And God punished Eve.
So what we are seeing here is punishment and not curses. But when it came to the serpent, he said, cursed are you among all the beasts, all the cattle, all the crawling things. You will go on your belly.
You will eat dust and so forth. So every one of you who worships Satan, you are actually a partaker of these cases. No matter how you appear like you are making it, you are just a sufferer. I'm sorry to say this. Satan is evil. The Bible describes him as a thief and as a murderer. He was a murderer from the very beginning. And he's a liar. When he tells lies, the Bible says he's just withdrawing from his resources. He has a bank of lies. He has a bank of hatred and jealousy and bitterness and envy. He has a bank of pride and pomp, selfishness. So when he tells a lie, he has no regret because that is of his nature. So he came to Eve as a serpent. And then he spoke to her. Has God really said that you shall not eat of any of the tree of the garden? He was telling a lie immediately from the statement. And Eve began to entertain the discourse. Said, well, God has said we shall eat of any of the fruit of the garden, but of the tree in the middle of the garden, the tree of knowing good and evil, God has said we should not eat and we should not even touch. Remember, the devil is getting from his own resource. When he tells a lie, he's just withdrawing from his bank. He's not only a liar, but he's the father of lies. Father of lies. The devil is not a father to demons. Those demons are his brothers. But the children of the devil, it is lies and the liars. So when you go and start telling lies, you have become an automatic son or daughter of the devil. The devil is the father of murder, which is sourced in hatred. When you have hatred, you are a son or a daughter of the devil. So then the devil answered Eve and said, ah, no. You know, God has not told you the truth. He doesn't just want you to know the good things and the bad things. He doesn't want you to be like him. And he stopped there. Listen, my friends. Temptation will come to everyone. The devil did not cause Eve to go and get the fruit from that tree. The devil only spoke a lie. And he's doing the same now. Eve personalized it. She took it as her own idea. When she realized the tree, when she eats of the fruit, she will become wise. She will become like God, knowing good and bad. And she looked at the fruit. Immediately it was appetizing. It was not the devil who went and plucked the fruit. It was Eve. She got the fruit and ate so that she can become wise, so that she can be like God, her eyes opening, and then she will know the good and the bad. And she ate, and then gave a portion to her husband who was with her. And when Eve ate, there was nothing that happened. Once Adam ate, the eyes of both opened. Once Adam ate, the eyes of both opened. The first thing they saw was their nakedness. Then when Adam looks at Eve, said,
ah,
this is how you look. Meanwhile, he looked at himself. Said, this is me. When Eve looked at Adam, is it you or it is another? She couldn't look at him. Before they ate the fruit, both of them were naked, but they were not ashamed of one another. But once they eat of the wrong fruit, their eyes open up and they saw they were naked, and they became ashamed, and disgrace attacked them. they were running away. Not to go and hide at the same place because they will be looking at one another's nakedness. This one at their own place. Another one at our own place. And they are to attempt to get the fig trees, the fig leaves, to sow something to cover their nakedness. There is no one who can take away your sins. Your money cannot buy you righteousness. You're going to church cannot take away your sin. You're reading the Bible cannot take away your sin. You're singing in the choir cannot take away your sin. You're preaching cannot take away your sin. There is only one thing that takes away human sins. And that thing that takes away our sins is blood. And in our case, the blood of Jesus. It washes us whiter than snow. In the Garden of Eden. And then God is coming. Because God loves relationship. He is a God full of love. He desires to relate with his people. He wants to talk to his people. They must relate with him. They must chat with him. He needs to hear their voices. They must hear his voice. He knew they had fallen. But because of love, he came to identify himself with them. To give them hope so that they can repent. He reached out to them in love. Adam, where are you? And Adam said, I am hiding. Why are you hiding? He said, I am naked. Who told you? Because before they ate the fruit, it was impossible for them to know bad things. It was impossible for them to know sin. Who told you that you are naked? Have you eaten of the fruit I forbade you? Instead of Adam saying, sorry, Lord, he began to accuse. Instead of saying, forgive me, he started to blame. He blamed God. The woman you gave me, she gave me and I ate. Adam's chance of repentance is past. To confess his sin is past. God gives us opportunities to repent and to confess our sins. He turns to Eve. What is this you have done? Hoping that you say sorry. Forgive me. I disobeyed you. What did she do? Accusation. It is that one. The serpent deceived me. God did not tell them, but I gave you the command. When you are fallen in sin, God is not coming to judge you. He's giving you an opportunity to say sorry so that you are restored. God is not coming with condemnation like human beings do. When someone sins against us, what do? First we scold them, we shout at them, we just mess up everything. By the time we are forgiving others, we will have finished them. They are no longer feeling like human beings. They will feel so desperately nothing. And they think all hope is gone. God did not condemn Adam. You need to pick that. And until now, God is not condemning you. God did not condemn Eve. But Adam condemned Eve, and Eve condemned the serpent. When it came now, God has done away with Adam and Eve. Then he went to the serpent. Because the serpent has already been judged from heaven. He did not say to the serpent, "Why have you deceived them?" To the serpent, he just came to pronounce cases. Never you be deceived to think you are cursed. If you are cursed, you went to the devil and got some curse from him. So that because you are so sympathetic, Mwamsanga satana na ase ndafima cases. At can you please give me a portion? I want to help you to carry. To the devil, he just began to say, cursed are you among all beasts, among all cattle. You will no longer have legs, you will be creeping. You will always be crawling. And I'm putting enmity between you and the woman whom you deceived. When you meet the two of you, there will always be war. The woman's seed will bruise your head. The head is a symbol of authority. And you will bruise his heel. I would rather have my heel bruised than the head bruised. In short, God is still exhorting man that he made. He's still believing they will find a chance to repent and come out of their sin. He has not taken away their authority. When Adam and Eve had sinned, they passed their authority to the devil. And then God, after having done all, before he did that, he had to kill animals, atonement by blood. There is power in blood. Your blood is powerful. That is why God says, don't eat meat with blood. When you eat meat with blood, you are eating the soul of the animal whose meat you are eating. God killed animal. And the first leather suits. The first leather garments. When I look at you today, no one is putting you on leather because they are very expensive. When God made you in his own image according to his likeness, he put his value, he put greatness in you, he deposited himself in you the way he is. So that's how you are. They chose fig leaves. He chose leather. God has not called you to a life of poverty. He hasn't called you to a life of suffering and continuous struggles. He has a good plan for you. Jeremiah 29:11. A plan to prosper you. To give you a future. And to give you a hope. God desires good concerning you. That is why in John 10:10, the Bible says, I am come that you may have life and have it abundantly. In Psalms 31 verse 19, he talks of how good is your goodness which you have prepared for those who fear you. How good is your goodness which you have kept for those who trust in you in the presence of people. We are not worried of the famine that has come upon your land. We are not worried of the poverty that has hit Zambia. Why are we not worried? Because the one in us, his anointing is in us. He teaches us in this way that worry not what you are going to eat, what you are going to put on, what you are going to drink. Worry is not for the children of God. Worry is for the Gentiles, the unbelievers. But for you, you must seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these drinks you desire, all these garments you desire, all these foods you desire shall be given unto you. He said, don't you see the birds of the air? They don't spine. They don't advance. Don't you see the flowers of the field? Not even Solomon in his pomp had such kind of garments. Don't you see how the animals live? The birds, all they know is there will be dinner for me, there will be breakfast for me, there will be lunch for me. That's why he put Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden, where there was more than enough. And Jesus Christ came to restore us to a life of more than enough. Hear me, Jesus Christ. The Bible says the one Jesus who was rich, he became poor so that us who were poor should become rich in him. Wealth and riches are of God. They are not from the devil. The devil stole from Adam and Eve. When Adam and Eve refused to repent, then they were separated from the land of plenty. They were thrown out. Why did they refuse to repent? Because the spirit of an orphan, which is the spirit of a devil, it had entered them. And so they could not say sorry. And until now, any one of you who is not willing to confess their sins to God, you will live in thorns and thistles. You will be beaten by snakes. Diseases and sicknesses will never leave you. Poverty will never run away from you. Cases will be your dress. It will be your suit. It will be your shoes. Because why? You are behaving like the devil.
Janet Wadia, Etchingola resident, suffered from a problem of stiff neck for 1 year. This woman was unable to turn her neck without having to turn her whole body due to the excruciating pain. She then decided to come to the Life Cathedral in Chingola to see the man of God, Bishop Joseph Kajila, who later prayed for her and administered anointed water and oil. 3 months later, Madam Judith Walia comes back to testify to what God had done for her through his anointed servant. And according to her testimony, this woman received her healing upon prayer of the man of God. Let us listen to a wonderful testimony.
Leave a neck, I say, leave a neck, leave a neck, leave a neck.